filled with your body and blood, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you shed your blood to save your people. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, in the gift of your body and blood, you give your people life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
have mercy. You Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest.
On earth, peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray.
Whoever eats this bread will live forever. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh and the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us this flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's an old story about two men chopping firewood. The men were said, "This is a hard saying." Many of his disciples abandoned him after he told them to eat his flesh and drink his blood. I imagine that if they thought Jesus was only speaking symbolically, they would not have found his saying to be too hard, too difficult to accept. They would not have abandoned him. They obviously took him literally, and we can do no less. The literal sense of his words can also be seen in his reaction to the disciples that abandoned him. He let them go. He didn't reach out to them. He didn't seek them out. He didn't call them back. He let them go because they found the saying of eating his flesh and drinking his blood too hard. He turned to the 12 and asked them, "Will you go away too?" And they decided to remain. St. Peter's response was, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of everlasting life." Peter wouldn't have responded that way if he didn't accept the teaching that Jesus was giving him, that he must eat his body and drink his blood to have life with him. The first Christian said, "The cup of blessing, is it not sharing in the blood of Christ?" We heard that in our second one. Only a literal belief could warrant Paul's warning that whoever eats this bread or drinks this cup unworthily is guilty of the body and blood of Christ. The church is always taking Jesus' words concerning the Eucharist literally, and there is unanimous belief for the first 1500 years in the church. The Council of Trent, the First Vatican Council, the Second Vatican Council, Mysterium Fidei, the Catechism of the Catholic Church, just to name a few, take the words of Christ concerning the Eucharist literally, not symbolically. There are many presences of God in the world, but the Eucharist is so unique that we simply call it the real presence. It's so unique that we adore our Lord Jesus in his body and blood in the Blessed Sacrament. There's no real great explanation of how this all works. It's not a matter of science. It's a matter of faith. That Christ is really and truly present in the Eucharist. And he feeds us with his flesh and blood. And that is really and truly present within us. It's up to us to accept the life the Father gives us in the Eucharist or to reject it. God does not force the Eucharist upon us. Does not force this belief among us. God simply reveals himself and feeds us with his body and blood and nurtures us with his body and blood. It's up to us to accept this gift that God wants to give us. May God bless you with all love. I believe
in one God, Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten
Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father.
Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. And by the Holy Spirit, the incarnate of Virgin Mary, became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And rose again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, and the giver of life.
Proceeds with the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is the Lord glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic
and apostolic Church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My sisters and brothers, by offering his body and blood for us, our Lord Jesus reconciles the world to the Father. Therefore, let us present our needs before our God in repentance.
For the church, that we may worship the mystery of the Eucharist with ever deeper faith and devotion, that all Catholic parents, especially in the Diocese of Joliet, will support their children's interest in vocation, the priesthood, and consecrated religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, that the human hunger for peace and justice will be satisfied, for an end to the coronavirus pandemic, that as we struggle with the pandemic, the Lord God will protect us, grant recovery to the stricken, strength to those who care for them, and success to those who are working to eradicate the scourge. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, for each member of our families, and for each member of our parish, that we'll continue to grow in faith, love, and hope as we receive our Lord Jesus in his body and blood. And for all the intentions written in our book of prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a greater respect for the dignity of all human life, from natural conception to natural death, for an end to abortion, the death penalty, euthanasia, poverty, and war, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick or suffering in any way, that they may be consoled and strengthened by God's love. For all those who have died, especially in that one era, that they will rest for all eternity in the heavenly kingdom. And for all those who grieve the dead, that they may find peace and consolation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass, Angela Fasola, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and loving Father, may we who worship the mystery of the Lord's body and blood always experience within us the power of his redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread, we drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you and help us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. And we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into
temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Amen.
Let us pray.